Hello everybody, my name is Phaethodas, welcome to this video. This is my build, my new build, which is an old build of mine. I call this build Patched Bolts because this build is supposed to be playing with pets. It is a pet build, but it also plays with the Doombolt skill. And actually not only the Doombolt skill from the Occultist Mastery, but also Doombolts that we get from items. For example, the Void Blade, which grants the skill Doom Bolt, it has a 15% chance when hit to trigger. This is the idea behind this build. This is why I call this build Patched Bolts. And here we are now. This is the Tomb of Watchers. This is the last tomb where the last big boss of the game is. But the big boss of the base game, not the Malmuth expansion, the Ashes of Malmuth. We are going to the boss Logorian now, to kill Logorian. Which is the big boss of the main campaign. The big and ugly boss, very ugly boss. So, this is what we will be doing here. I'm going down there. I don't know if I can do it without dying against the boss. I don't have the best resistances out there. I'm still building this character. This is veteran difficulty. I play on veteran, as we can see up here. Normal mod, veteran difficulty of normal difficulty. Veteran mod of normal difficulty. And I think it is better to be playing on veteran mode because you get more rewards, maybe a little bit more experience points. Yeah, mostly for the rewards, I would say it is better. It is also a little bit more challenging for those that find normal mode to be very easy. Playing veteran mode, it is a little bit more challenging, so it is a very nice mode for the game. Now we have to clear this dungeon. We are in the first floor of the dungeon. As we can see, this is the first time I pass through this area. This is going to be my first battle against that boss with this build. Now, as I said previously, this is an old build of mine, but I play it again on a new character. Actually, I'm remaking this build. The first version of the build, the first character that was playing with this build never reached the level cap 100 for a variety of the reasons that I don't remember right now, it doesn't really matter. But with this second version I'm going to make it. Actually, the first version, when I started playing the first version, there was no Ashes of Malmuth expansion outside. We had no expansion yet. But now, this version is the version that was made. I started playing this character after Ashes of Malmuth, of course, came out. And now I have the big picture, the big plan in my mind for this build, where I want to go, how it will go there, and all of these things that have to do also with the added content of the expansion. Added items or enemies, places to visit, and all of these things. And we will see. We will see how good this build will become in the end. I'm considering this version of the build to be the true version of the build, because with this version, I will take this version through the end of the journey. I will see it to level 100 to reach the cap, level cap with this character. And we will see. Of course, it is the same class. It is a Conjurer class. Both of the versions, the first version and this second one, they play the exact same class, same masteries. For the most part, same skills. And I'm killing enemies now. Nice. Let's go this way. I will explore the whole map. Because this is how I play these games. You know, games that have a standard world, not a randomized world, like for example Dungeons in Diablo 1. these dungeons are fully randomized. You know, of course, Diablo 1 is a very old game. I think many players that may be watching this video right now haven't played Diablo 1, they know nothing about it. In Diablo 1, the game plays only in dungeons. You have 16 dungeons. The dungeon number 16, level 16, floor 16, call it as you will, is the last one of the game, but there are 20 dungeons, 20 levels. The 16 levels are the standard, we could say, and the 4 levels come... how could I put it? They come from quests, and sometimes you get into these levels and play them, sometimes you don't. Sometimes you decide if you will get in these levels, sometimes you don't. One of the levels is a standard one. It is the level of Archbishop Lazarus. Yeah, this scumbag. What is that? Nothing. So, and 16 of the 20 dungeons, levels, actually not 16, it is 15. 15 of the 20 floors in Diablo 1 are completely randomized. Every time you start a new game and you go into the dungeon, the first dungeon, for example, of the cathedral, it has a different layout. It is randomized. And this thing is a great thing about dungeon crawlers because it brings lots of replayability to the game. And you, when you start a new game with your character, you never know where the exit is, where the entrance is, where the rooms of the floors are, what enemies you will fight against, and all of these things. Diablo 1 was something like a genius created that game, I could say. I mean, the idea of completely randomized dungeons was an amazing one. My pets are almost dead. So, when you play in dungeons like this, randomized dungeons, sometimes you don't need to go and explore the whole map, because the next time you will get into the dungeon with your character, you will have to again explore the whole map, and because the dungeon is randomized, it is a completely new dungeon. Of course, exploring maps is awesome in games like that, but in games like Grim Dawn or Titan Quest or maybe Sacred, in these games, we don't have randomized levels, dungeons and all of these things. Everything is a standard one. We have standard layouts of the dungeons and the maps and all of the world of the game. So, I like to explore everything, because when you explore everything, you unlock the full map and you have the map unlocked forever with your character. So your character gets the full experience of the world exploration, something like that. And this is why I like to explore everything. Of course, exploring everything is good also, not only to explore the map, to say that you have explored the map, but also to fight more enemies and get more experience points, level up faster, also to fight more loot. These games are all about loot. So you got to explore. Explore the maps, explore the floors, explore the levels, explore them all. Become an explorer. These enemies are easy. Oh, devotion level. Nice. Okay, let's go this way now. Here we have... what is that? Nothing. Void Parasite. Okay, I should pick up the iron bits from the ground, actually. I don't even know why I don't pick it up. Flame Turret has reached rank 13. Very nice. Let's go this way. Oh yeah. So for this build now, the Patched Bolts build. I'm trying to increase my chaos damage output because of the Doom Bolt. This Doom Bolt skill is a main skill for this build. And increase chaos damage, we increase the damage output of the Doom Bolt. And I'm also trying to put more points into pet skills, also devotion constellations that have to do with pets. They give bonuses to pets, you know, resistances, survivability bonuses, damage is very important because you got to make your pets as powerful as possible. You got to make them very fast to attack very fast your enemies. Chthonic Seal of Biting. And this is what we try to do here. Come on. They would kill me here. What is that? This is not a hero. Summon this pet. This is a very powerful pet. War Sword. This primal pet here. The primal spirit. Nice. Let's go this way. There is some unexplored area here. Of course, the battle against this boss is going to be very challenging. Even if I am able to kill these many bosses of this dungeon fast and easy, that boss is going to be very challenging. Especially when it will start summoning many enemies of its own. It also summons minions. And this is going to become a problem. But I don't know, we don't know, you never know, maybe I can do it without dying. Who knows, who is it? Come on, come on. No secret areas. Okay, that was not very good. One of my pets is dead. Summon two pets. Nice. Let's go this way. We are getting there. We are very close. This is a tiny place left here to explore. There is a boss here before the entrance. We can also hear the footsteps of our pets. They sound very nice. A very nice sound effect. I have 4 pets currently in my disposal. 3 pets are standard pets until they die at least, and one is the primal spirit, which comes here. It lives only for 20 seconds, but it is a very powerful pet actually, so it is okay having only 20 seconds lifetime. It is fine. Taka taka taka. Nothing. Let's go open a portal here in case, you never know, in case that I die. And here we have the boss. The Thalonis Bloodlord. Oh. This Thalonis Bloodlord. Whoa, yeah. Come on, Thalonis Bloodlord. Die. Die, please. Yes. Nice. Let's go kill the enemies here. Yes, we have some enemies. Okay. Sealed in, what? The sealed in is a. It is something like that. A text. Text, text. The final seal. Where is it? Sealed in, yeah. A final seal. Okay. I will not read all of this text now. If I read all of these texts, I will gain experience points, but I will not do that now, because in case that I gain experience points but not enough experience points to gain this level, to level up, and my points, experience points go somewhere around here, for example, and I go inside the boss and fight and die from the boss, I will lose some experience from the boss. So some experience that I gain from these things will be lost. It is better to use these things after the battle with the boss. Now, let's put spirit. Activate the pets. Open the portal. Let's go for the boss fight. Take that. There was a bud called Take That, Pop Bud, back in the day. Okay. We are doing it. Nice. My pets are dead already. Wow. Okay. That skill's not ready. My pets are dead already, yeah. This is going to be a big problem. Do I have... Yes, I have. Very nice. Beautifully beautiful. Beautifully awesome. Yes, I survived this. Okay. Let's do that. We can do it. Come on, baby. Come on, baby pets. Hit this guy. The big, bad, ugly boss. Yes, I can do that. No! What the... Okay, summoning my pets again. Wow, really? Okay, here we go again. Nice. Come on, primal spirit, I want you. I need you in my life. In my life. In my life. Primal spirit, kill them all. Yes, come on, we did it. Yes, enemy boss killed. Very nice, very nice. So this bit, it seems very promising for the future. This battle was challenging, it did, but I did it. I did it. Okay, very nice. Just a blue item. Beautifully beautiful. This was a 100% successful attempt. Nice. Okay, I can see a bright future for this build now. Guys, this is it for this video. I will see this build through the end of the game, of course, and we will have more videos and live streams also. I have already live streamed this build a couple of times. We will have more live streams in the future. Maybe we will also play some multiplayer with this build in Crim Dawn. And thanks for watching this video. I will see you very soon with more content, videos, live streams and all of these things. Stay tuned, subscribe if you haven't done so, and if you like what you see, of course. If you don't like what you see, don't subscribe. And I will see you very soon, and have fun whatever you are doing.